Hey everybody, this is Rido, and we are back with another recording of LEGO Batman 3 Beyond Gotham. And we
Someone
are.
must put an end to this injustice. Preferably someone other than me.
Yep. And we are with the Green Loon Toon here on Quord, and we're gonna do a quest. Let's do it. We only have a couple things left
that
to do on Quord.
Slippery scoundrel Say What Straw had the citizens of Quord under mind control, forcing them to dig for bricks, I think. I wasn't actually paying attention. But hey, they've been digging against their will, and I think we can agree that's not right. Go round up those poor saps so we can flush Sinestro's insipid influence from their brains.
So this is dangerous because this is the exact quest before where we couldn't find that third group of people that we were looking for. So we're looking for, I assume, these guys. And I bet I need the demolition suit to blow this up for them. He's free. So now I take him back. Now what I need to keep in mind and look for is how quickly do those guys show up? See, I'm like way over here and the number two is over there. Easy to see. So we're blowing up the ball and chain on him. Need to go back to the demolition suit. Blow that up. Bring him back. Follow me before you get exploded. Can you fly? No. We're gonna have to take the long way, I guess. Up here. He can jump up here. And this way. And maybe this way. What's this ball? No, nothing that way. How about this way? Seems like we're taking the long way around. I wonder if I just ran to the Green Loon Toon if he'd figure it out himself. If his pathfinding is that good. He can clearly see we're going the wrong direction. But every direction we go seems to be the wrong direction. Says it's like, yes, we see he's in the total wrong place. Will he make it? How about this guy? We'll take him with us too. Now they're both following me. And I got
How many miners does it take to dig up a brick? Sounds like the start of a bad joke, doesn't it?
So we got all three of them. We're supposed to talk to him, I guess?
That slippery scoundrel Say What Stro had the citizens of Quard under mind control, forcing them to dig for bricks.
Yeah, that's the thing. But we got all three of them. Unless it was three out of four. Unless all of these things are just bugged out. Could be that they're all bugged out too. Let's try this race. Go up, up, up.
Help!
Gold brick collected, good. So we're looking for another Thundarian? Is that what they're called? Flying around, trying to stay somewhat to the surface of the planet, so we didn't don't
Thank goodness
miss
you came by. This situation is
Ignore most Adam West.
To say the least.
We can't save him yet. Here's a guy. Alright, maybe he's the last one. Follow me. Can I make it to the Green Loon Tomb this way? Yes, I can. 4 or 5, really? Why are there free play switches is the real question. There's no point in which you could have reached these areas and not been in free play mode, I don't feel like. Maybe you could have, but I don't think you could have. Doesn't seem like you would be able
Help.
To. Because you have to get to the moon base to be able to get to these planets. And I think I was only able to get to the moon base after we did all the story and were in free play mode. So unless there's something I'm missing, those switches are redundant and never useful.
No.
We
no,
never
no,
play
no,
a story
no.
mode or anything. Here we're looking all over here for the fifth Thundarian. Again. Not sure that's the name. Let's see. There is something here we could do. Pull the switch, it gets a platform, that means we can double jump and get up here, come down, press the B button to charge this up, laser beams are turned off, good. Fly up here, fly over here, hit that B button again, break that, get that gold brick. Well, almost to 125. 15 more. Where are you, the final brainwashed slave of Sinestro? Where are you hiding? So, it kind of starts to make sense why these worlds are so small when we have quests like this. Here he is. Oh. But really, they should have just gotten rid of quests like that. These, they're not fun enough to direct the creation of entire levels. Let's see. Am I going the wrong direction, or am I going the right direction?
Who did this to me? Could it have been the Joker? Penguin? Riddler? Or even Catwoman?
Apparently running the wrong direction, but I feel like I'm running the right direction. If only the game wanted to agree with me. Is the other guy gonna be able to follow me? Is he still following me? Man, if I lost that guy. Here I am. So, it would be nice if you could just figure out how to walk to me from here. If I just stood here long enough. Where's the guy? I lost him at a certain point there. Let's go this direction then. We'll just follow this path and hope this leads the right direction. Go this way, perhaps. Go this way. Go maybe this way. No, that's no good. How about this way? Why are you? You're stuck. That way. We're getting close. So close.
Looks like that's all of them. Now, if you'd care to stand back, I shall attempt to cure them of their mind control. Ahem. All right, snap out of it! Yeah, it was worth a shot. Don't worry, I'll make sure to get someone more scientific-like to take a look later.
Gold brick. So, where are we at as far as Quard is here. We have no more gold bricks, just two more quests. So Mostly I just need to fly around and find another quest giver, which is gonna be the Green Loon Tern, obviously.
You got a second to help out your good buddy, Green Loon Tern?
Here he is. Two more quests and we'll be done.
Say, when did this planet turn into a big spherical zoo? I just saw a rat being chased by a cat, being chased by a dog, being chased by what looked like a cross between a crocodile and a filing cabinet. Things would be a lot more peaceful around here if somebody would round up those blundering beasts.
So if the animals are embodiments of fear, that makes sense. But they're not. We have a cat being chased, a rat here that's an embodiment of fear, being chased by... Let's take this guy out.
I realize this request may seem a little strange coming from a duck, but help me get those animals under control, will ya?
So, it's the same mission as before. So this is Super Mutt. What is Super Dog called? It's not called Super Mutt. That wouldn't be the right name. Crypto, the Super Dog. That's his name. A lot easier to pull this one off than the one before.
Okay, roll
but
call.
Very repetitive.
Sinister spectral rat? Check. Mangy, mean looking cat? Check. Strangely excitable super dog? Check. Deadly giant crocodile? A killer croc, if you will? Check, check, check. Nice work. Now I just need to figure out how to get them into their little pet carriers. I can take it from here, bub.
So, one more quest, I believe. Somewhere, we just need to kind of fly around until we hear the Green Loon Tern again in his new location. Might be worth it to fly towards the light. Go towards the light, they say. If that's the case, this would be it.
Thank goodness you came by. This
nope,
situation is most
west.
Unpleasant, to say the least.
What a mess! I can't believe my eyes!
Mr. Freeze. Interesting. Demolition suit. Open this gate. What do they want? Why are they
Who
on
left
board?
My cryogenic freezer open? Kill a moth! I'm looking at you!
What? I didn't leave no fridge door open to bask in the glorious glow and no tiny light bulb! You can't prove nothing!
You'd better run, you pestilent parasite! Oh, drat! The fuel cell has run completely dead! The entire contents of this freezer will be ruined if it thaws! Quickly, find me another fuel cell!
Find a fuel cell? What's the hint here?
Another hint? What am I, the Riddler?
You may need to borrow a fuel cell from another machine. There must be something around here that can be dismantled.
So we're looking for a blue minikit, and we may need to use our sense abilities to get it to work. Here we have bats. So, if we switch to Batman in sensor suit and hit B. Why am I supposed to hit B? Oops.
Curse that lollygagging light bulb lover!
Switch back to a spacesuit so I can fly back up there. Let's try this again. That didn't seem to go quite as I had hoped. Press here for B. Press this for a clue. Come on. What is the B prompt again? There it is. So we get this whole giant arrow of studs that we're just going to ignore. Here we are. Am I going the right direction still? I mean, how far is too far? Must not be that far, because here's some more bats.
Hello, friend. You haven't noticed any strange-looking people around here, have you?
Well, it's pointing me back this direction. So it must be in this piece of equipment here. Yep. Okay. Pick up that fuel cell and off we go. Which way to deliver it? I think this way. I think this is the way. I don't know if I'm gonna end up going the whole circle of the planet. Come on, get up there, whatever. We'll jump on the edge here. There we go, finally. Made it back.
You may need to borrow a fuel. Ah, perfect. Quickly now, hand it over. There's still time to rescue these poor fish sticks from certain doom. Hmm? Well, you didn't think I would keep my important research in a communal freezer, did you? With idiots like Killer Moth about. I've lost many a ready meal to that imbecilic insect. But thanks to you, tonight's fish stick sandwich is still on the menu!
So we unlock Mr. Freeze, which... I suppose Mr. Freeze is gonna be slightly useful. Is that the end for Quart, though? Or do we have one more thing we can do here. Nope, that's the end for Quard, so we'll just save ourselves some time and travel to the moon base. Right from the menu. This is a really nice effect. I'd like to see this effect in more games, honestly. So, from Quard, we now go to Yzmalt. And I don't know if there's an actual number of gold bricks you needed to build all of these, but if there was, I long since reached that limit. Here we go. We'll go ahead and do the grand tour, unless there isn't a grand tour, and then we'll check to see how many collectibles are in Yzmalt.
You're gonna want some expert advice before exploring this place, bub. Rest assured, dear traveler, that while it looks like we've taken a terrible tumble back through time, this prehistoric-looking place is, in fact, present-day Yzmalt. With those hot-headed red lanterns around, it's not the safest place to be walking around alone. So how about you let me show you around?
So, third time we've walked around the planet for no real reason. Not great. Not interesting.
Hold on to your tail feathers. Here comes trouble.
Even anticipating having to walk around, fight a few guys, and then having to walk around some more and fight some more guys. I mean, even the anticipation there is boring. What isn't boring, however, is that there is a building I saw over that direction that looked like a Earth
Please
building.
Please hurry and save me. My Aunt Harriet must be so worried.
Duck Dodgers in the 24th and a half century!
What would be an interesting thought, the one long-running comic book that isn't run by DC or Marvel, one of the longest ones that's not run by those two, is Archie. I don't know if you could do a Lego Archie, though. Archie seems to probably be more character-based and not that action-oriented. But I would love to see some more Looney Tunes comics. I know, at least for a time, both, I think, Marvel and DC released Looney Tunes. And at this point, Marvel has no excuse not to be releasing Looney Tunes cartoons, because they're owned by Disney, which I think owns Looney Tunes. I could be wrong about that. Let me think about that for a second. They should, at the very least, Marvel is owned by Disney, so there should be Bugs Bunny, Mickey Mouse comics, and all of those Disney character comics, all those things should be coming out on
Hello?
A monthly basis.
I'm TV's Adam West. I don't suppose you could lend me a hand?
But last time I checked, DC was just kind of randomly at times releasing kids comics, even like Teen Titans Go and stuff like that, that could easily be released every month like every other comic book, were coming out every 2 months or so, just really, really long.
Say, what's the big idea? It's not even duck season!
Same old gags from the Green Lunter in here. I guess I would take the Green Lantern over Kevin Smith or Conan O'Brien walking me around these planets, but just barely. What I would prefer is if Martian Manhunter gave us that quest. And he says, scan the planet, walk to these specific points so that I can get our bearings or something like that. And then there was just little markers where you were supposed to walk. Well, you just followed streams of studs.
Phew, we made it back. Not that I was scared, of course, but I could see that you were beginning to feel the heat after those last few giant, monstrous... skeletons. Anyway, where was I? Oh yeah, I was on my way somewhere far less ominous than deadly. Toodles!
Alright, gold brick. So, what does Yzmalt have in store for us next time? That's Zamora. Here's Yzmalt. We've got 7 gold bricks, 4 more quests, 1 Adam West in Peril, and 3 characters. So they're staying pretty close to where they're supposed to be. And look, Yzmalt is right next to the story level on Yzmalt. And Awkward Situation is right next to Awkward. Ah, I see how this works. But Breaking the Ice is next to the moon for some reason. That was on Earth. Okay, whatever. However they decided to lay this whole thing out doesn't really matter. But what does matter is we are at 32.4%. We have 72 out of 147 character tokens. So we are close, very, very close to 50% of those character tokens unlocked. We have 114 out of 250 gold bricks, we're close to halfway there, and we have 9 out of 30 Adam West rescued, which is pretty good considering 16 of those are going to be inside the levels. And yeah, we are done with this recording too. That's it for this recording. As always, I ask you to like, share, subscribe, comment if you want to, and watch every second of my videos. All that helps me out. If you want to support me, you can click on my name, Rido. On the right is a blue button that says support this channel. Click it, make a donation. And if you want to friend or follow me on basically any social media sites, there's a whole bunch of links down below. Thank you for watching. Have a good evening.